हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ 10th क्लास, आई थिंक इन आवर प्रीवियस डिस्कशन वी वेर अंडरस्टैंडिंग 9 टू 10 क्वेश्चंस। टुडे फ्यू मोर क्वेश्चंस, द मोर वी डिस्कस ऑन डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस द मोर यू बिकम परफेक्ट, सो दैट व्हाट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस मे ऑकर आर व्हाट टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस यू हैव टू डिस्कस इन आवर प्रीवियस इन आवर फ्यूचर examinations. So today we start from the question number 11. Identify the substance oxidized and reduced in the reaction. This is the very easy question. It is the reaction between copper oxide and zinc to give zinc oxide and copper. Ore is removed from copper oxide to make it copper. Okay, and oxygen is added to zinc to make it zinc oxide. So addition of O on zinc or converting zinc into zinc oxide is oxidation. That means this has undergone oxidation. So the substance oxidized is zinc. When zinc is oxidized, this copper oxide has undergone reduction. That means copper oxide is reduced, zinc is oxidized. Question number 12. A student took 2 to 3 gram of a substance X in a glass beaker and poured water over it slowly. He observed bubbles along with hissing noise. The beaker becomes quite hot. Identify X. What type of reaction is it? Oh. This is, we bring tuna from the market. Okay. So when you put tuna in the water, it becomes hot, and at the same time it gives hissing sound, hissing noise. So that means substance X is calcium oxide, chuna or quick lime. When CaO reacts with water to give CaOH twice, this reaction comes under the category combination reaction. Okay. Now question number 13. Write the balanced chemical equation with state symbols for the following reactions. I think already they are balanced. Kindly go through and check it in your free time. Question number 14. Substance X used for coating iron articles is added to a blue solution of a reddish brown metal Y. The color of the solution gets discharged. Identify X and Y. And also the type of reaction. See, first you see the clue what he has given in the question. Substance X is used for coating iron. So whenever we study about iron, the important topic of iron is rusting of iron. So to prevent iron to undergo rusting, the best way is what? We coat zinc on the iron. So X is what? Used for coating iron articles so that it prevents iron to undergo rusting, and that zinc is added to a blue solution of a reddish brown metal Y. Blue solution is copper sulfate, so this is blue solution of reddish brown metal Y. This metal is copper, so copper sulfate is a blue color. Copper is reddish brown. Its salt solution, copper sulfate, is blue color. So here he is adding zinc to blue colored copper sulfate. When we add zinc to blue colored copper sulfate, what is the reaction? Zinc is more reactive than copper, so zinc displaces the copper to give zinc sulfate, and the copper is made free. So the color of the zinc sulfate is colorless. So therefore, earlier, before the reaction, it was blue color. Now color is discharged, no color. That is the answer. So X is zinc, Y is the metal copper. Type of the reaction is displacement reaction. 15th, a student burnt a metal A found in the form of a ribbon. The ribbon burnt with a dazzling flame and a white powder B is formed, which is basic in nature. Identify A and B. Write the balanced chemical equation. Okay, this is regarding the magnesium ribbon. So metal A is what? Magnesium, which is available in the laboratory in the form of ribbon, When this magnesium ribbon is burnt, it gives white color dazzling flame, and the powder formed is magnesium with oxygen gives magnesium oxide. So A is magnesium, okay, and B is what? B is magnesium oxide. But here he has used X and Y. So in the previous example, I used no, and the same thing continued. This is A and this is B. Reaction is Mg plus O2 gives 2MgO. This is white colored magnesium oxide. Why should a magnesium ribbon be cleaned before burning in air? This reaction is a first step to the this reaction. So why you have to clean the surface? Because magnesium is the most reactive metal. It comes under the top 5. Therefore, immediately it will react with the atmosphere and forms magnesium carbonate layer. So that layer is always on the, it will be there on the surface of magnesium metal, which makes magnesium slightly inactive for the next reaction. Therefore, whenever with sandpaper, if you rub, clean it so that magnesium carbonate layer is removed, then fresh magnesium is seen and that is used for the laboratory purposes. This reaction, I think it is directly taken from the textbook and already I discussed. So this is very easy for you. It is a kind of recapitulation or it is a kind of a revision. Next question. Substance X is used for whitewashing. Name the substance X and write its formula. Write the reaction of the substance X named in 1 above with water. Okay. Substance X is used for whitewashing. Same, chuna brought from the market for whitewashing. So what is X here? X is CaO. And CaO with water gives CaOH twice. This is like a butter, slaked lime. This we apply on the wall. Okay, so this is the reaction. So X is what? X is CaO. In refining of silver, the recovery of silver from silver nitrate solution involved displacement by copper metal. Write down the reaction involved. So what he has said here, he has asked to write the reaction between silver from silver nitrate. Okay, so silver nitrate is AgNO3. So to remove Ag from AgNO3, we have to select such a metal which is more reactive than the silver, that is nothing but copper. So when the copper is made to react with the silver nitrate, copper being more reactive than silver displaces the silver, so that silver is formed and that is recovered and used for the ornamental purposes. Displacement reaction, single displacement reaction. Question number last. What do you mean by a precipitation reaction? Explain by giving examples. This is a new type of reaction for you. Precipitation is what? Whenever we mix two salt solutions, two metallic solutions. So out of the two products, one of the products is solid, which is insoluble. Because it is solid, it occurs as a precipitate. That is known as what? Precipitation reaction. Best example we do from 10th, 11th, 12th is reaction between AgNO3 and NaCl. So this we do in the 11th class to test the presence of chlorine in the given salt, what you are going to learn next year. This is called double displacement reaction. So first sodium is more reactive, goes and displaces Ag and forms NaNO3, and AgCl forms AgCl is white color that comes out as precipitate. Okay, when the white precipitate forms, that indicates reaction has happened. Thank you guys, thank you for being with me to discuss the 10 more questions, and in our next class we discuss many more questions so that this chapter is made perfect and we'll go to the next chapter.